In this video, we are continuing with the design of this reinforced concrete building. The modeling of this building in the StartPro software was completed in the last video. In this video, we will be assigning the member sizes and other specifications as may be required. Let us open the StartPro software, Structure 1. This model was created in the last video. And now we will proceed with assignment of member sizes and specifications. Before we proceed, let us just have a look at the beam orientations. If you are planning to do a concrete design of this building using the concrete design module available inside the StartPro software, it is important that you make sure the member elements which are continuous should be having their local axis pointing in the same direction. This is required for the StartPro software to identify these members as continuous as in actual practical construction. But if you have followed the same procedure which I followed in the creation of this structure, you can be sure that all continuous elements will be having their local axis in the same direction. Let us switch off the display of beam orientation. Apply. Okay. Now we will start assigning the member sizes. In our building, all the column sizes are 250 by 400, while all the floor beams at the first floor and the terrace floor will be having a size of 250 by 450. The staircase roof beam and the plinth beam will be having a size of 250 by 350. Let us define the sections in StartPro. Rectangle. All columns will be 0.45 by 0.25. All beams will be the beam size, and columns will be 0.40 by 0.25, and plinth beam and roof staircase roof beam will be 0.25 by 0.35. Okay, let us select the column size and select all the columns, that means beams parallel to the y direction, and assign. Yes. Now we will select the floor beam size and select all the floor beams. Assign. Yes. Now we will select the plinth beam and the staircase roof beam size. Yes. Now this has completed the assignment of member sizes to all the structural elements except two beam members which are at the staircase mid-landing level. So let us select the 25 by 45 size and select by missing attributes, missing property. So these two beams have not yet been assigned any member size. So we will assign the 25 by 45 size also. Yes, so this completes the assignment of member sizes. You can have a check by missing attributes, missing property. No entity with missing property is found. Okay, and you can also have a look at the 3D structure. Here, let us have a look from the top y direction, and let us switch on the display of structure diagrams and sections outline. If you see that all the columns are oriented with their major direction in the x direction, but in our actual structure all these columns are oriented along the z direction. So what we have to do is create a beta angle of 90 degrees. Okay, and select it, and select all the columns, that means beams parallel to y, and assign this beta angle. So again, let's have a look from the top of y, and we can see that all the columns are oriented in the same direction. Let us switch off the display of the section sizes. Now the specification tab, we are not assigning any specification to the structure at this point of time. We will be having a detailed visit at the specification tab at a later time. we will create a fixed support for all the column bases. Let's select all the column bases. Sign. Yes. This we have also assigned the required foundation support, that is fixed supports, to all the columns. Now now we will go to the load and definition tab. We are not going to create any lateral load like seismic load or wind load at this point of time. What we will do first is create the dead load case and the live load case, and we will do a gravity analysis, and then later on we will come back and assign a lateral load requirements, and then we will do a complete analysis of the building. So we will start with the load cases, and we will add a dead load case. Let us name it as dead load, and then we will add a live load case. Let us name it as live load. And so we have created the dead load and the live load. The application of the loads will be continued in the next video.